Hello, and welcome to this month's episode of What's New with Microsoft 365. I'm Vivian.
I'm Candace.
And I'm Arthur, and we're all your hosts for this month.
And like many of you, we're working from home and will be for the time being.
And there's been no better way to collaborate remotely with our team than with, you guessed it, Microsoft Teams.
March is actually the 3-year anniversary of Teams.
And we wanted to cover a few exciting features to celebrate the anniversary, like improved audio quality in meetings,
targeted communications for firstline workers using the Shifts app in Teams,
and Teams and Skype consumer interop capabilities.
So let's get started.
First update is a great one for those of you that have been in or tried to troubleshoot meetings with poor audio quality, especially if someone in the call had a weak Wi-Fi or cell connection.
Now, with new algorithmic improvements in Teams, like reduced data packet loss, your organization will experience a smoother audio quality across meetings, even under congested and lossy networks.
When joining meetings over a Wi-Fi or cell connection, high packet loss can adversely affect the call experience.
For admins, this means a reduction in needing to troubleshoot audio quality across your org's team meetings and calls. These improvements have rolled out to Teams customers worldwide.
If you're supporting an organization with first-line demands, you might be happy to hear that Kronos Workforce Central integration is now available with the Shifts app in Teams.
For the uninitiated, Kronos is a suite of tools and services designed to manage your workforce or employees, as well as provide other services related to human resource management.
And now with version 8.1 of Kronos, you'll be able to integrate it with the Shifts app in Teams for the following scenarios: to view a schedule, publish request open shifts, swap shifts, request time off, and offer shifts.
This integration between Kronos and Teams is important because it allows you to support your first-line end users in the previously mentioned scenarios, as well as enabling them to use all the collab features that Teams has to offer, right from their mobile device or desktop, and all without having to switch contacts to another app.
To learn more, check out the technical documentation in the description below. And in other news, to support first-line workers, targeted communications is now here in Teams.
For your first-line managers using the Shifts app, they can now manually create @mention tags to organize employees based on attributes such as role or location, and then contact them all at once.
So, for example, say your first-line managers wanted to message people based on an attribute like on-call physicians or people working a weekend shift.
A first-line manager can now create this @mention tag and then use it in a new chat or channel post, and quickly bring attention to all the relevant people based on this @mention tag.
This helps end users by removing the guesswork out of needing to know who is or isn't on shift when you need to quickly communicate news.
And first-line workers are automatically assigned to @mention tags that match their schedule and shifts, which allows for integration with tools like Kronos and other major workforce management systems.
Businesses that use Teams will now be able to find and communicate with customers and partners on the Skype consumer app across all clients, including desktop, web, iOS, and Android.
This new interoperability will let your end users use Teams to chat and make audio and video calls with a Skype user by searching for their email address, and vice versa.
And for safety and security concerns, Teams users can accept or decline first-time conversations with Skype users and block and unblock contacts as needed.
To learn more about Teams and Skype interoperability, the admin controls that apply, and how to enable this setting in the Teams Admin Center, check out the description for more info. And that's all the show that we have today. We're keeping it short and brief.
If you're supporting an org that's using Teams, or if you're using it to work remotely, we would love to hear about the features you've relied on most to stay connected and productive.
We'd also like to do a special shout out to our behind the scenes crew for helping us keep the show running this month, even with all of us working from home.
Woo!
And finally, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the show if you haven't already. And we'll see you all next month. Bye.
Bye.